It's Talk Funny, a podcast by Mark Bailey and other comics from all over. We ended up in Japan because we wanted to see a place where mayonnaise is considered a salad dressing. The Talk Funny podcast from NagoyaRadio.com and Nagoya Comedy. Here's Mark Bailey.
This is Mark Bailey. We're back with Talk Funny, and we're here with Tofi. It's been a while since you've been here. Welcome back.
Thank you. It has.
Tofi is eager to talk about something that's been out. It's been out for months now, but...
Me.
He's been out for... I thought you've been out for years. Dave Chappelle's special was called Sticks and Stones, and some of the left did not like it, and he kind of predicted that. So what's your take? You said you wanted to unload on it.
As the token Arab homosexual in Japan, I give it an 8 out of 10. I thought it was very relevant, and I really appreciated his sincerity. And people on the left don't like it because, well, not everyone, I can't speak for everyone, but my friends sometimes refuse to even watch it because they say that he's being transphobic or he's being, like, too old-fashioned. But the most important part of that is that he's being truthful. He's not just saying, like, oh, you know, I'm gonna like, sing the liberal song and I'm going to go vote Republican in the polls. You know what I mean? Like, he's being his true, authentic self, which is very, very appreciated. Admittedly, I like the second half more than the first. I really liked his LGBTQ car analogy. I thought that was ingenious.
I thought that was funny, yeah. Very funny. Is it true?
It's, we don't hate lesbians. I love lesbians. I wish lesbianism were contagious.
In the States, I don't have only two gay friends, but I have two gay, very close friends. Two are gay guys, and one is a lesbian. And all four of us are very good friends. And they always say, we love the lesbians. The lesbians say, I love my gays, right? But then when there's a fight, it always ends with the F word epithet from the lesbian, or the L or shut up lesbian from the gay guys. Maybe it's kind of horseplay, it's kind of well meant, but it would be the equivalent of at the end I just say, shut up Arab, you know, something like that. We've been getting along for so nice, and now you end it with that.
Well, it's just because each side knows the other's, not weak point, but, like, sensitive point. And, of course, they'd use it in a fight. I mean, who wouldn't?
Yeah, I guess it's more like brothers and sisters where, you know, at the end, one of the siblings will say...
Bed wetter.
Mom always liked me best anyway, and slam the door, right?
Something to get... Yeah,
all right, so was it true about the car? So I think people... I don't want to do spoilers, but I think everybody's seen it. But basically, if you haven't seen it, Dave Chappelle... compared the, and he couldn't even finish the whole thing. He didn't finish the whole alphabet, what he calls the alphabet people, LGBTQ, but there's P.
I don't know, man. We keep balkanizing ourselves as a community, and I just can't stand it. I really cannot stand it.
But LGBTQ, everybody knows what that is by now.
Kind of, yes. But see, the thing about Dave Chappelle that I did not appreciate was how ignorant he is of our issues. It's like straight men to pretend to be more masculine, make themselves as ignorant as possible about our issues. They're like, oh, gay people, yeah, I've heard of them. I don't know what they do or what they like or what they go through, but yeah, I've heard of them because, you know, I'm a macho straight man who doesn't even have any link to that kind of, you know, lifestyle and whatever. I thought everything was on point. I personally do not hate lesbians. I love lesbians. I thought the queer part was the best. Because I can't stand when someone tells me they're queer. If you tell me you're queer, you're telling me I'm gay and educated. That's what you're telling me. I don't really appreciate queer people, and there's a lot of people who are actually in the LGBT community. I don't really say the LGBTQ. LGBT community who also can't stand queer people.
Someone told me, oh, they didn't like the B being included. Some gay guys don't like, because they say, well, you're bi, you're just, it's like curious and bi. And it's like, pick a team or something.
No, man, don't pick a team. But if a guy can sleep with a woman, then come home to me. I'm going to love him even more. I just, something about straight men allures me. So bi is like God's gift to what he cursed and blessed me with.
And I'm trying to think of what he said about the T. He said nobody really knows what to do about the trans people.
Yeah, that's the part that was most, contentious, I'm going to say, among my friends. Now, yes, he did make fun of trans people. Let's not get it misconstrued. He did make fun of them. But let's just remember that gay men have also been made fun of for years and years in American media. Like in the 70s and 80s, we were always the butt of jokes. We were always like the feminine stereotype, weak, emotional, slutty, two-dimensional characters. We had to be ridiculed so that we would be pleasant. We would become pleasant. The same thing is happening now with trans people. Okay, Dave Chappelle is not telling us they're bad people. No, he's telling us what he sincerely thinks. And yes, it is confusing to the common person when they hear about what trans is. actually, if I didn't have any trans friends, I wouldn't buy it completely either. But because I have trans friends and they're sincere and I've seen and I've heard accounts from them, and they're not being like, oh, you cisgendered, you know, scum or whatever. You know what I mean?
Right.
So what he's doing, I think, is a great service, because throughout the whole set, he is establishing himself as a centrist who leans left. So when he says that he acknowledges the trans experience to be a legitimate one, albeit a funny or unconventional one, when he does that, he is convincing people who are also in the center to be more accepting of trans people. He's saying these people are inevitably present and natural, and okay, maybe you think there's something wrong with them, but we should never be violent towards them. He's not being, you know, he's not saying they're terrible people. He's just saying they're in a quirky predicament.
And the way I watch this is the way I watch all these specials is as a comic, okay? His duty is actually to entertain us. Mm-hmm. He's not supposed to... His duty is not to get up and say, I just have this one bit I want to do, and it just says, please respect everybody and treat everyone as your brother and sister. Good night!
Next!
That's not funny!
Next!
I want my money back.
Yeah.
It's like Led Zeppelin. They reunite and they come and they play hymns. I want to hear Stairway to Heaven. I want to hear Stairway to Heaven. We've converted. We're Christians now.
Uh-huh.
I want to hear Stairway to Heaven. You're Led freaking Zeppelin, right?
Uh-huh.
So I thought it was funny and I expected him to do this and I'm glad he did. But I can understand that some of the community would be angry. The one part he said was, look, trans, I talk about them because they're funny. He said, look, if you're a guy or a girl and you're born in the wrong body, that's hilarious. It's not for you, but it is to the comic.
Well, to be fair...
And that's called punching down, actually, which is difficult because you have to be careful. That's all Japanese comics do is punch down. They make fun of foreigners, they make fun of children, they make fun of invalids. And that's all Japanese comics do, generally, and they think that's funny. You can do a little bit, but you need to punch up, too.
Sometimes they intentionally make us laugh.
Who, comics?
Japanese comics.
Because
I laugh at them all the time without them intending.
Yeah, they don't realize they're a parody of themselves. So let's get back to Dave Chappelle. So what did you think about that when he said, trans, nobody really understands them, and that's why it's kind of funny?
Well, Mr. Chappelle, you can do some research about them and understand them more. Just because they're peculiar does not make them an automatic bullseye, especially because they go through the worst experiences. I'm talking about trans people in the West, because trans people in the Middle East is a whole other story. In Iran, the government funds sex reassignment surgery, so on and so forth. But in
is
the
that
West,
in between throwing them off the roof or what?
Well, no. See, if they can fly, they're given like, oh, you can fly. You must be holy.
But the thing is with Dave Chappelle, name a group that he didn't make fun of. He made fun of everyone.
I mean, he did.
What he said even about the gun control. He said it's not a problem until you give black people guns.
Yes.
And then watch. Now we got a problem.
Exactly.
And it's funny because there's always truth in it. If he says something that's funny that has no truth in it, it's not funny to you.
I was humbled after watching that special. He is amazing. The only two things he lacked are the voice that he had when he did Killing Them Softly, which I think is the best set ever.
Right.
Ever.
Right.
Like, remember when he said... when they're talking about the kids in the commercial who want like apple juice versus apple drink, and he does that voice.
Yeah, yeah.
What the hell is juice? I want some apple drink. You know,
right,
that
right.
Register is no longer there, unfortunately.
Right, right.
It's a golden pitch. And also, of course, the drive to make money. What he's doing now is legacy work, so he doesn't have to like appeal to people more. They will laugh at whatever he says. He's just like the comedian, you know? He can tell me about his day and I'd still laugh about it, you know, even if it's like the most boring stuff.
Right. As a comic, and I was watching, and if George Carlin or Richard Pryor were alive, they would have had to tackle this by now. Louis C.K. would have tackled this by now if it weren't for his scandal, and I like what he said about that. As a comic, I'm saying, look, Louis C.K., what he did in front of those girls wasn't right, but he was in, like Dave Chappelle said, he was in his hotel room.
Yeah.
He asked permission.
Yeah.
You can't give permission and then take it back later.
Yeah.
And okay, even if he has permission and it's not okay, what's the penalty? You can never work again? That's a little harsh.
What people misconstrue about the left is that they think it's one homogenous body. It isn't. There's lots of self-criticism on the left, and there's lots of abuse on the left as well. You see lots of people who are minorities making fun of majorities. People make fun of white people for not being able to dance or like have sex properly, which isn't true,
or,
you know.
You know, penis size, whatever.
Yeah.
It's also not true.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of abuse on the left as well, which is not acceptable in my opinion.
Which is ironic, because the left now wants to blacklist people because you offended my group. And they were the first people to rightfully protest McCarthyism in the 50s, which was, if you've been said you're in the wrong group, you can never work again. And they have such short memories, they've forgotten now. We're really headed into a very dangerous area. Go ahead.
Yeah, I also think an important point for people to remember is that nobody represents everybody. So, for example, if you tell a black person, okay, you're black, they can say, no, I'm African-American. Another person can say, oh, no, I'm not African-American, I'm black. Nobody really truly represents the minority group that they're in. So for these people to be all outraged on behalf of everybody else is a bit, like, is a bit deceitful.
Also, the car analogy with the LGBTQ, and the problem with lumping everyone into that group is, the one thing they have in common is they've all endured abuse, and keeping secrets, and facing losing their job if they come out or something like that. But the solutions to each of their groups are different. The bathroom problem really doesn't affect lesbians.
That's true.
Bathroom do I go? It doesn't really affect gay guys.
Men would be happy to have you in their bathroom.
Gay guys are happy to be in the men's room, right?
Yes, they are.
Right? So
yes,
it only affects T's. It only affects the trans.
It really does, yes.
And so we don't know what to do about it, because it's getting to now where gays and lesbians are also raising children, and we have to think about children with some guy who's been, he's been on testosterone for 35 years, and now he's in a dress, and he's peeing next to my daughter. And so we have to think about children. It's not that you're going to do something weird. It's that I'm not ready to have that talk with my 7-year-old yet. Maybe I should, but you don't decide that. I'm the parent. You don't decide when I have that talk. And maybe we haven't had the talk yet. And so that's the thing is, I think the solution is, I did this on stage one time, is just go to single bathrooms. Just single. Every bathroom is a single bathroom. Anybody can go. You can have a Chewbacca can go to the bathroom. Anybody, right? One other thing I liked from his special is that he said, what was the part he said? He wasn't allowed to say the F epithet.
Uh-huh.
And they said, well, you can't do that because you're not gay. And he said, well, I'm also not the N-word.
But I don't understand. I don't understand because, see, he makes it sound like it's some ingenious quip, but I don't find it ingenious at all, because he was referring to that to himself as that for a long time.
Well, no, he has actually an older bit, and so does Chris Rock, and they talk about the difference between, to be real careful here, you know, the N-word ends in an E-R. And then the rap words end in a guh. He said, there's a difference between ER, NERs, and guhs. He said, there's a difference between black people and N-words. Because guy buys a house, and he has a lawnmower, and he has a car, and some other black guy borrows the lawnmower and never gives it back. That's the N-word. Not me. The black guy's not an... Just because you're black doesn't make you an N-word. That, he has a whole bit about that. And he said, I love black people. I hate N-words. So basically, they kind of call each other that as well. It basically is as if we said, for white people, we would just call... He's an a-hole. Doesn't matter what his color, but that's what, you know, that's what he meant. That was callback.
They're not the representatives of their community, and I can imagine some people don't agree with them on this at all. Oprah, for example, doesn't want that word to be used in any context whatsoever. You have people in the UK who think the N-word is actually a compliment because it originates as like a term for royalty in Ethiopia, or what it is today, Ethiopia, at least. So I don't buy that. Like, when people who are minorities kind of abuse me into respecting a certain facet about their identity, I'm like, well, okay. But you don't speak for everybody in your minority group. There's no consensus on this.
What he was making is basically, the joke is not about that. His joke was about, she thinks I'm an N-word.
Yeah. Well,
and she thinks I'm not an F. His joke was, she thinks that if you're gay, you are the F-word.
Mm-hmm.
And that if you're black, you are the N-word. Because this was a white woman. That was the whole point of the joke. And that's the way she thinks was, well, you know, those F's over there, that's the way they talk to each other. And those N's over there, they talk to each other like that. And he said, I'm not a member of either group. I just happen to be black. Don't call me epithets. That was his whole joke.
I don't really buy it. I think he was just using it to kind of like snap back at her or something and get like a huge round of applause from the audience, because he was like, oh yeah, you know, like I'm like a smart person, you know. But an interesting point
She was calling him that. That's the whole joke. I mean, as a comic, trust me, that's what he was trying to convey. That's the punchline. It's a meta punchline.
Uh-huh.
It's a joke about the joke. It's as if I said, you can't say homeless because you're not homeless, but you can say the F word. That means I think I call you that in my spare time. That's what that means.
I didn't interpret
maybe
it that
you
way.
Be called, well, that's what he means. It's a comic, trust me, and that's exactly what he's trying to do. And that's how most people took it. But you took it like offensively?
No, I wasn't offended at all. I just found it interesting, because if you can say the F word, can I say the N word? You know, you know what I mean? And I don't really care about the F word or the N word at all.
Well, that's a stereotype also that blacks, that he doesn't do anymore. He used to. And what's his name? maybe Damian Wayans, maybe? He had a recent one, and it was very almost old-fashioned. It was like 80s, 90s stereotype, and I'm really tired. Most black comedians don't do this anymore. But they used to say, white people that like rap music, they want to be able to say the N-word. They really want to say it. I don't.